This is Skip Cunningham, your entertainment reporter, reporting on the unbelievable success of the 1988 Viking Variety Show. No, but the surprising news comes from a prof, Joe Noble. This man, take a look at these eyes. This man, his hypnotic act, is making people stand up and take notice. The man is hypnotizing people from all over, and people are starting to take note. Well, I can see that the show is about over, so let's talk to a few people and see what their views on the show were. Sir, excuse me, what were your views on the Viking Variety Show?
It was a very, very, very good show. I would see it again and again and again. It was even better than Cats.
Outstanding. Here comes a lovely couple. Yes, he's lovely. Let's see what their views on the show were.
It was a very, very, very good show. I would see it again and again and again. It was even better than that.
Thank you. Deep Space, or The Great Wall of China, and a freshman in William 352. Someone did a study on most often heard phrases here in Chicago, and the number one was, hey, taxi. Two is, what bus do I take to get to Michigan Avenue? And number three is, don't worry, it's just a flesh wound. Now, it's time to take a little visit with our friends Frank and Fred and let them show us how to be good house guests. Fred wakes up to the sound of chirping birds. Fred wakes up on the patio, distraught. Fred helps Junior conduct science experiments. So does Frank.
Unbearable. star yesterday from my best friend back home. Had a satellite picture of the entire Earth on the front. On the back he wrote, "Wish you were here." How was this?
Right.
What's your guess for the secret song, Joe?
Dead Saint Nick.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Dead Saint Nick.
No, I'm sorry.
Check again. I want to view it.
But let's give that Christmas number a spin anyhow.
Up on the rooftop, reindeer call. Then I hear a crashing fall. Out to the window, clickety click. On the front porch, a dead Saint Nick. Oh, 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 who's got a dog? Ee, just a little me. Out to the window, clickety click. On the front porch, a dead Saint Nick. To the doorstep I do run, thinking now I'll have some fun. Quick change of clothes and what do you see? Old Saint Nick is just little me. Oh, 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 who's gonna know? Just little me. Quick change of clothes and what do you see? Old Saint Nick is just little me. Into the sled and off I fly, streaking across the Yuletide sky. I'll visit your home on Christmas Eve. I'll take all your presents and then I'll leave. Oh, 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 who's gonna know? Just little me. I'll be a millionaire because I found dear old Santa Claus.
Just pull up.
for a coffee. He said, "Hey, I don't tell you how to do your job. You don't tell me how to do mine." Speaking of cable lanes, we have a pin hat here in this thing. Well, it's not what it used to be.
Good. taking my case to court.
Let's try to guess that secret song, and please, please, try to do a better job than the last caller. I know you listeners are out there. Now, here's an interesting thought, and a hard to believe fact. The pop tart is the only food that can be mailed like a postcard, and incidentally, with no loss of flavor. That's hard to believe, isn't it? And here's another thought. And this is a puzzling question. If you melted down dry ice and tried to swim in it, would you get wet?
What?
The
be suspicious. And for those party animals that want a true history of Chicago, here's a little fun you can have with some of the Chicago cabbies. When you get your destination, say to the driver, "Hey, I was hitchhiking."
To see October. case.
It's time for the news headlines here at WDMC. And you know, there's a group studying the federal budget, and more federal waste was discovered today. Professor of Pharmacology at Penn State just got a $150,000 grant from the U.S. Public Health Service to develop a time-release placebo. On Nancy Reagan's recent birthday, she said she was 61, although records reportedly showed she was 63. Her explanation, she doesn't count the 2 years she spent in the National Hockey League. My luck has been bad lately. I looked at my birth certificate the other day and it had an expiration date on it.
I don't understand why you're so angry.
I'm not angry. I'm stinking furious.
Oh, you're just mad because Maureen Allen won the costume contest and you lost because you were stuck in the same costume you wore last year.
Well, I don't see how 18 rolls of saran wrap constitutes first prize. Besides, it wasn't even the costume that you were interested in, just the filling.
Yeah, what about you and Howard Rosenblatt? You went out on the balcony alone.
He just wanted to breath the fresh air.
For an hour?
Well, he's a slow breather.
Right. What is so funny?
You look better in that dress than I do.
Yeah, I guess I do look pretty ridiculous. It was a pretty good party, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
What about that hypnotist? What was his name?
Joseph. Joseph Noble.
That's it. Great guy. Great guy.
Wasn't that hysterical how you had that couple quacking like parrots?
Yeah, that was pretty funny. But, honey, I just don't think it worked.
Could you imagine if it would have? Could you imagine me acting like you and you acting like me at a clap of a hand?
It's amazing how silly a man can act when a woman places the slightest bit of attention to him.
Well, she did have that way of catching my eye.
I don't have to stand here and take that from you. I'm going to bed!
What just happened?
I don't know. I just went blank. This is scary.
Don't worry. It's okay. Let's go to bed. I'm tired. I'm gonna get out of this bra.
Are you sure?
Cross my heart. Let's go to bed.
And I'm tired of the way you've been treating me lately. If you don't like it, then find someone else. You can't talk to me that way. After 11 years, you can't talk to me.
I'm sorry. Come on, dear. You know that I love you.
Do you really?
Come on, let's go.
No, that's not. I have a headache.
We're back with WDMC. Now, here in Chicago, we have an area we call Chinatown. And every year, with Chinese New Year, there's a lot of firecrackers and things going on at all hours. And the mothers, well, they calm their frightened children by telling them, it's just gunfire. So... Foster and the Rockets.
I was sitting on a pew enjoying something new when the preacher said, "What are you doing there?" I said, "I'm doing nothing." He said, "Doing something.
What?
You're picking them greasy burgers during prayer." I was picking my
Oh! Your talents are astounding.